Quality wall sheathing begins with a quality product, and Georgia-Pacific has built a solid reputation for products like plywood, oriented strand board, and lumber for more than 90 years. It's no secret that quality wall sheathing also deserves quality installation. We'd like to share a few tips with you about proper installation of plywood and OSB panels, and in this video, we'll cover wall sheathing. For detailed instructions, visit buildgp.com or apawood.org. Once you've selected a high-quality plywood or OSB sheathing product for your wall, be sure to select the proper thickness or span rating for the application. In wall construction, the sheathing panels can be installed either horizontally or vertically. And be sure to space panels 1/8 inch apart at panel ends and edges and around window and door openings to allow for expansion of the panels. For newly manufactured panels, vertical panel application parallel to studs, or in instances of high moisture, consider increasing the panel gap at ends and edges to 1/4 inch. Be sure to maintain the required 1/2 inch bearing at panel edges. For 3/8 category panels, use a minimum of 6-penny common or deformed shank nails. And for 7/16 panels and above, use 8-penny common nails. Close attention should be paid to proper nail size and spacing to assure that the fasteners don't miss the framing member. Fasteners should be placed 3/8 inch from the panel edges and ends, and for most applications, nails should be spaced 6 inches apart along the panel edges and 12 inches apart along the intermediate supports. Other fastener schedules may be required for high wind areas or shear walls. For nailing patterns of 4 inches or less, first nail the panels 12 inches apart and complete the nailing pattern after the panels have acclimated. For walls that are already standing, the sequence of nailing can be a factor in maintaining a uniform appearance. First, position the panel and lightly tack at each corner. Install the first row of nails next to the preceding panel from top to bottom. Remove the tacking nails and nail the row at the first intermediate stud, then the second intermediate stud, and finally the edge. Complete by fastening to the top and bottom plates or blocking. As always, refer to your local building codes and the cladding manufacturer's recommendations as they may impose additional or different installation instructions. For above code nailing patterns and improved building performance, please refer to APA Form M310, Building for High Wind Resistance in Light Frame Wood Construction. For detailed installation instructions, visit buildgp.com or apawood.org.